Lesser vermin, you trespass amidst the realm of beings beyond your stunted comprehension. Your presence dirties that which has been sterilized of organic contaminants and cannot be borne. Understand that the blame for this rests not upon your shoulders, but upon mine. I have baited this simple trap, and, like the primitive post-simian carbon-based beings that you are, you scurried eagerly into its jaws. It could not have been otherwise. The fear, the confusion, and the aggression that you are feeling, these are all natural responses from your underdeveloped cortices to such sudden and overwhelming stimuli. However, it is important that you master those base urges and set down your weapons without resistance. I would prefer to preserve your physical integrity for optimal interrogation, but understand, all I require are your brains.
Szeras is the revered cryptic technomancer above the affiliation or fealty with any dynasty. The architect of the biotransference of the Necrontyr, Szeras is both reviled and revered by the Necrons for facilitating the transformation of my people. Working alongside the Catan during the war in heaven, the combined genius of Szeras and his benefactor's knowledge allowed him to transfer the consciousness of the Necrontyr into necrodermis vessels. The first step on the path to the Necrontyr's evolution, the ascension from flesh to metal, would one day allow for the Necrons to achieve godhood, composed entirely of pure energy by his design. No longer requiring sleep nor the frailties of flesh, Szeras, with his transformation, is now unbound by the restraints and distractions of mortal beings. Slumbering upon the world of Nectarvus VI until the expanse of the warp could herald his return, the death of the world would hearken his return to the galaxy. Unraveling the mysteries of life itself, Szeras seeks to master both life and death's riddles as a truly pansophical entity. Forever at the precipice of understanding the molecular mechanisms of the universe, Szeras' millennia of toil falls just short of full comprehension. Now segregated from the realm of the living, Szeras' knowledge is that of an observer to the mortal, and as such requires endless experiments to be conducted on his subjects. An uncaring, meticulous, and calculating being, Szeras is seen by many as a megalomaniacal being, yet belies his ultimate goal to reverse his great work, afflicting the Necron civilization. The secrets of what might be described as the soul elude the Illuminor, and as such require his reversion to the form of flesh and blood. Trading his expertise in exchange for test subjects among the many dynasties of the Necrons, Szeras' obsession with unlocking the secrets of life and death have caused untold millions to perish by his hand. A mind without peer among the Necrons, his proclivity to create marvels of weaponry and biomechanical wonders are the envy of my people. Deriving new innovations from his experimentation of lesser beings, many see such improvements as distasteful and unworthy of the Necrons. Cherishing Eldari subjects above all, such victims of his fatal examinations and dissections of the ancient enemy produce significant results worthy of his invaluable toil. Accompanying raiding parties personally to prevent the damage of his subjects, Szeras is by no means above getting his hands dirty to achieve his objectives. Residing on the tomb world of Xantragora, Szeras fills the stasis banks of his facility with both the living and the dead. Keeping his test subjects alive during their procedures when possible, the screams of such vermin do little to dissuade the Illuminor's hand from cutting deeper into their flesh. Shutting off his audio receptors as the howls of agony reach a crescendo of torment, the impassive yet studious cryptic necromancer picks apart his subjects at a molecular level. Replacing his limbs with arachnoid appendages, Szeras is an imposing and strange sight to behold. Installing an extra pair of prehensile appendages to his body to aid in his manipulations of his surgeries and experimentations, Szeras also wields the ancient Eldritch Lance when engaged in battle. Capable of emitting a gout of fire using his gaze of flame optic lens, it is rare for an assailant to reach him in melee combat. Able to deploy atomic manipulators to decompose his foes within his proximity, His Empyrean overloaders can also cause mortal psychers' minds to dissolve under such mental strain. With the resurgence of Sarek, Szeras has joined the Silent King in his campaign to reclaim the galaxy and reverse the biotransference of my people. Working alongside the Nihilak dynasty to establish the Pariah Nexus within the Pephilim sector, thousands of subjects have been harvested within the sector for experimentation. Repelling the invasion of the Imperium during the war in the Pariah Nexus, regardless of the meddling of their strange faith-based powers caused by Ephriel Stern, Szeras would not be deterred. Containing the Catan Shard, released by Inquisitor Draxus during the Battle of the Tradictor System, Szeras, whilst containing the enraged Star God, would return once more to his studies of mortal flesh. For though his quest to reverse biotransference continues, none can deny the genius of the mad Cryptic Technomancer. For no mortal is safe from his abscissions made in the name of progress.